Today, as promised, I'm going to cover the second F of the South. And for those of you who haven't figured it out, it's family. I know, family's important everywhere. There's large Italian families up north, and I know family's a big deal everywhere. But here in the South, it's more than just size. We're rooted here. I'm actually sitting on my front porch, which was built on my great-grandfather's land, and my great-grandfather had a lot of land. This is a book of my grandmother's family, and we've been living on land in South Carolina and Georgia since 1792. And this book covers all the family members from about 1792 till 1988. So when I say we're rooted, we're rooted.
Family is everything. Family is our support.
Well, Sue and my wife, we were both in the Navy, and when I retired, she was from Hartwell, so we decided this is where we were going to stay. I'm from Philadelphia, and I just didn't want to go back to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, so that's the main reason why we settled here in Hartwell, because of family and the area itself.
Daddy Kay and Granny Kay raised their family here, and I was 12. Brothers and sisters. Mama was one of the sisters. And Mom and Dad moved back here from Atlanta. And I was born here. Mark and Jeff were born in Atlanta. Been here ever since. And with Granny Kay and Daddy Kay being next door, when all the cousins would come down, we had the benefit of having a lot of fun with them. So it was really nice growing up. We had a great childhood. I got two brothers, two sisters, and I'm the middle child. It was fun. And sometimes it was hard, when your brothers would pick on you, or if you and your sisters got in fusses, but most of the time we all got along good. We're very close. With Mama's family, as big as they were so close and so loving with each other. It was just hard to imagine that many siblings loving each other the way they did and how close they all were and how much they loved their parents. So Granny Kay and Daddy Kay did a great job raising them. Yeah, the road that I live on is Viola Wynn Drive, and that's after Granny Kay. And the Kay Nursery Road's after Daddy Kay's nursery. White Dog Lane, and for y'all that ever read To Dance with a White Dog, that's what it's named after.
Lula Jean. Now, the reason I forgot Thomas, he died when he was killed when he was 20 years old. Lula Jean Thomas, Sarah Nail, and I think I'm the sixth one. So I'm the seventh. You know, one of the special ones. Then after me, Toombs. After Toombs, Pat, Peg, your grandmother. John, Terry, and Gary. And we are still a real close family. You know that, Valerie, how close we are. I came here when I was born in Oakwood, but I came when I was a baby, they moved back here to the farm. My grandfather bought this land, I think, in 1800 and something, from McGarity. About 150 years, I don't know, something like that. I got married, we were gone in service for 20 years, so we lived all over. So I not lived here. We came back here when my husband retired and built here on the farm. Oh, it was home. And it's a place that my husband loved. Fred loved this place. Look around you. It's just paradise, really. I imagine Terry had, from the very beginning, had that desire in him. Now, the first book he wrote was about the year the lights came on, about us getting electricity here. And it was so factual that I don't see why he had to sell it as a fiction. You know, To Dance with a White Dog was one of the most, yes, it was his most recognized book. And it was very, some of it was imagination, of course, but it was very true, a lot of it. Oh yes, it was a real dog. And we really didn't see it for the longest. I'm saying most of White Dog story was true. He put a lot of things that actually happened in there. And we didn't see, the dog would not come around me at all. But it was all over Daddy. It would stand up, put his paws on his shoulder, and Daddy would use that walker. Well, that's the reason it's called the To Dance with the White Dog, because he would kind of dance around the yard with the walker and the dog. And he did say, in my presence, that's your mama, come back to watch over me. And we just felt like, and he felt like, he told us finally, he said, just quit looking for her, because it came to lead me home, and that's where I'm going. And we never saw the dog again after he died. But of course, there's been a lot of white dogs that showed up here, so he might be coming back in another form. The McGarrettys he bought it from are buried up here on the hill where Papa and Peg are buried in that cemetery.
Uncle Terry and Uncle John donated their part of the land. There's already an old cemetery up there back in the 1800s. And then they took the rest of that land and got permission for the family to use it. So we get to use that to be buried there. Well, to me, you know, you'd be at home, you know, and that's it. Even if I lived way off, I'd love to be buried here.
All families have traditions, and in my family, we have an overall tradition. Yes, you heard me correctly, an overall tradition. These overalls were bought for my uncle in the late 1950s, early 1960s. And every kid since then has had a picture taken in them. My southern roots go deeper than I could have ever imagined, from traditions, century-old land, and even novels written about my family. Next week, I'll be covering the third and final F of the South. And remember, down here, everyone's like family. So y'all come again now, you hear?